Hello everyone, welcome to StudyIQ. In this video, we'll do the current affairs of 23rd of November. So let's start the video. Now before I start today's current affair, I want to discuss some of the questions that were asked in the DSSSB JE exam. This is for the junior engineer position in the DSSSB framework. So these four questions I will discuss. Who won the Pulitzer Prize 2019 in the fiction category? Pulitzer Prize is given for literature, for media also, and in the fiction category, it was given to this book. Now, this book is written by Richard Powers, and the name of the book or novel is The Overstory. The Overstory. Since the Pulitzer Prize is given for so many different fields, so many different novels like fiction, non-fiction, literature, poetry, and it is not always wise to remember the name of all, but you can remember about only one category, which is the fiction category. So in fiction category, it was given to this book, The Overstory, written by Richard Powers. Which athlete won the Khel Ratna, that is Rajiv Gandhi Khel Ratna Award, for para-athletics? Her name is Deepa Malik. And this question has been asked four times in the last 1 week itself. In fact, in the Gujarat clerk exam, Gujarat state clerk exam also, it was asked yesterday. Which program was launched by Indian Council of Medical Research to eliminate malaria by 2030? India's target to eliminate tuberculosis is 2025 and malaria is 2030. The program that was launched is called Mera India. Mera India. Now, what is this Mera? Mera is Malaria Elimination Research Alliance. Malaria Elimination Research Alliance. Which cricket team was suspended by International Cricket Council on July the 18th for violation of their constitution? When we say violation of their constitution, it means violation of ICC's constitution, that is ICC's rules and regulation. For too much government interference, Zimbabwe was suspended. Remember, there were two teams that were suspended for different reasons. Zimbabwe was suspended and Nepal was suspended too. But now, both the teams have been reinstated, which means they can play cricket again, Zimbabwe and Nepal. And as I told you before also, ICC has three positions. One is the president, Mustafa Kamal, CEO Manu Sahani and Chairman Shashank Manohar, headquartered in Dubai. Now these are written in Hindi, but I will translate it in English for you. Basically what they are asking is, there is a player called Harmit Desai. He won which award this year in 2019, and this award was given to him by the President of India. Now this is your clue. President of India gives Arjuna Award, Dronacharya Award. So the answer is Arjuna Award. Arjuna Award is given to exceptional performing sportspersons, and it was given to table tennis player Harmit Desai. You also have to remember Harmit Desai is a table tennis player. And another player you need to remember from table tennis is G. Satyan. He became the first ever Indian to be in the top 25 ranked players in the world. And Sharath Kamal, he became 9 times national champion. And there are others also, Mahuma Das and Manika Batra. Who is the Solicitor General of India? It was asked. So he is Tushar Mehta. It's been over a year now since he's been the Solicitor General of India. Then it was asked. Yeah, this actually is the same. Now, Western Zonal Council, where was their latest meeting held? Remember, any zonal council in India, Eastern, Western, Northern, Southern, Central, the chairman is always the Home Minister of India. So remember, Western Zonal Council was presided over by the Home Minister Amit Shah. It took place in Goa. Goa. And remember, Goa has a port also called Mormugao port. Even Vasco City in Goa is a harbor. And Goa has Bhagwan Mahavir National Park, which is called Mollem National Park, M-O-L-L-E-M. Now, Dadra Nagar Haveli, they come under the jurisdiction of which state's high court? Dadra Nagar Haveli doesn't have its own high court. It comes under the jurisdiction of the Mumbai High Court. And remember, these are all the questions from GSSSB Sachivalaya, that is the Gujarat clerk exam. So I am discussing not one but two exams questions. Then it was asked, who is the Lokpal of India? Lokpal is Pinaki Chandra Ghosh. Pinaki Chandra Ghosh. Then it was asked, which cricket stadium in India is named after Arun Jaitley, the former minister for finance? So it is the Firoz Shah Kotla Stadium in Delhi. Firoz Shah Kotla. Then it was asked, who is the new governor of Telangana? Telangana's new governor is Tamilisai Soundararajan. Tamilisai Soundararajan. Who is the president of Indian National Science Academy? For the first time, a woman became a president. Her name is Chandrima Saha. Very important question. Chandrima Saha became the first ever female president of the Indian National Science Academy. Who was appointed the principal advisor to the Prime Minister of India? The principal advisor to the Prime Minister of India is P.K. Sinha, former cabinet secretary. Now let's come to the questions of today. The Defence Research and Development Organisation DRDO has decided to put its over how many patents for free access to industries for commercial exploitation. Actually, they believe it will help industries in research and development. So they are making available there more than 450 patents. 450 patents. And G. Satish Reddy is the chairman of DRDO. There was a mission of DRDO also called Mission Shakti. Mission Shakti, where we did ASAT test. And this Mission Shakti is to basically have the capacity to destroy the satellites of other countries. That is Mission Shakti. Which among the following agencies will host the first ever CTTX, that is Counter-Terrorism Tabletop Exercise for the Quad countries? There are four countries in Quad. The countries that have Malabar exercise, like America, India, Japan, and the fourth one is Australia. So, the four countries in Quad are India, Japan, America, and Australia. CTTTX was an idea that was promulgated by the National Investigative Agency or NIA. NIA. Also remember, India has done recently three or four very important exercises. So for example, there was an exercise done with Uzbekistan called Dust Link. Dust Link 2019. And it was done near Tashkent, the capital of Uzbekistan. Another one that was done with Qatar is called Zayar al-Bahar, which means roar of the sea. Zayar al-Bahar with Qatar. And one more with China. That will take place in December, called Hand in Hand. And we will do it in Meghalaya. And with Qatar, we will do it in Qatar only, near Doha. And then one was done very recently with France, called Shakti, in Bikaner, Rajasthan. And one more, which was done last week, Indian Coast Guard exercise, Resurrex, last week. It was conducted in Goa by the Indian Coast Guard. Indian Coast Guard head is K. Natarajan. Which city will host the Destination Northeast Festival? Destination Northeast will be conducted in Varanasi. Yes, the city of Varanasi, where the first multimodal terminal of India was inaugurated by Pradhan Mantri Modi. First multimodal terminal of India was inaugurated by Pradhan Mantri Modi. Now remember that the second multimodal terminal of India, second, was inaugurated at Sahibganj by again Pradhan Mantri Modi. Sahibganj is a city on the bank of River Ganga in Jharkhand. So there are two multimodal terminals that have been inaugurated so far. First one in Varanasi and second one in Sahibganj. Okay, let me ask you a question here. Let me make it a bit difficult. There is a military exercise called CARAT, C-A-R-A-T, CARAT 2019. This exercise was done between which two countries? CARAT 2019. Write down in comments. Since we are talking about Northeast, you must know that there is a separate ministry for the development of Northeastern region called DONER. It is headed by Dr. Jitender Singh. Dr. Jitender Singh. And in Northeast, recently a book fair was organized in Guwahati. Northeast Book Fair in Guwahati. There was a Northeast Film Festival also in Guwahati that was organized recently, where Iran was the focus country. Which IIM institution has signed a MOU with Lal Bahadur Shastri National Academy of Administration, Labasna, to run a joint training program for politicians, bureaucrats and businessmen? This IIM is IIM Indore. IIM Indore. Now the businessmen, bureaucrats and businessmen, they will get training at Labasna. Labasna is where the IAS, IPS and these officers, they are trained. Labasna is in Mussoorie. Mussoorie, which is in Uttarakhand. Also remember, recently IIM Bengaluru, they started Mahatma Gandhi Fellowship Program. Mahatma Gandhi Fellowship Program. Mundarwa Sugar Mill, it was inaugurated recently. It is located in which state? Mundarwa Sugar Mill is in Uttar Pradesh. Uttar Pradesh Chief Minister is Yogi Adityanath. Anandiben Patel is the governor. And UP Police, they recently started an initiative called Savera, where they want to help senior citizen. So the senior citizen don't need to come to the police station. Rather, the police will go to the senior citizen's house and all the services will be at the doorstep. This is called Savera initiative by the UP Police. Also, they started Kanya Sumangal Yojana. Kanya Sumangal Yojana, where 15,000 rupees is given to the parents for taking care of the girl child. And Naroda Atomic Power Plant is also in UP. Then they launched a mobile app also. Not the mobile app. There was something else about UP. They first of all launched a booklet in the Katarnia Ghat Wildlife Sanctuary. It was about leopard, the status of leopard. Yeah, the mobile app actually is E-Ganna. Yeah, there was a mobile app. E-Ganna for sugarcane farmer. And there are some other wildlife sanctuaries also in UP like Suhelwa. Suhelwa has been asked in the exam. Suhelwa Wildlife Sanctuary. Then there is Kishanpur Wildlife Sanctuary. Actually, Kishanpur Wildlife Sanctuary is inside Dudhwa National Park also. And Dudhwa is in fact a tiger reserve also. Dudhwa, Pilibhit and Amangad. These are the three tiger reserves in Uttar Pradesh. Prime Minister Shinzo Abe has become the longest serving prime minister in the history of Japan by surpassing whose record? So whose record has he broken? He has broken the record of Taro Katsura. Taro Katsura. And now Abe has crossed more than 2,887 days in office. And Japan has a new age also. Now we call it Reiwa. The old one was called Heisei. And Naruhito is the new emperor. Now, Japan recently hosted the Rugby World Cup also, which was won by South Africa. It was won by South Africa. And in the Henley Passport Index, Japan and Singapore are the number one countries. India is ranked 86 in the Henley Passport Index. And there was a tennis tournament also called Japan Open that was won by Novak Djokovic. That was won by Novak Djokovic of Serbia. And with Japan, India does a military exercise also. We did it very recently called Shinyu Maitri. Shinyu Maitri. Shinyu Maitri take place? It took place in West Bengal at the Panagarh Air Base. Now, SITMEX is a military exercise between India, Singapore and which country? SITMEX is taking place between India, Singapore and Thailand. And Thailand. Remember, it will take place annually from 2020. It was announced by Rajnath Singh recently. The first SITMEX took place in September 2019 in the Andaman Sea. Who has been conferred the Lifetime Achievement Award by the ICMR, Indian Council of Medical Research? She is the founder, managing director and chairperson of Biocon, one of the biggest companies of biotech in India. She is Kiran Majumdar Shaw. Kiran Majumdar Shaw. Karnataka state has launched a scheme to provide free Wi-Fi to which city for 1 hour each day? Karnataka will provide it to Bengaluru. 1 hour free Wi-Fi. And the Deputy Chief Minister of Karnataka announced it, Mr. C.N. Ashwath Narayan. Also, Karnataka, you must remember, recently it finished number one in the Niti Aayog's India Innovation Index. Delhi was the number one union territory in innovation and Karnataka was the number one state. Then there are some items from Karnataka which have won GI tag in 2019, like the Sirse Supari of Uttar Kannada, Arrow Turmeric, Babu Budangiri Arabica Coffee, Chikmagaluru Arabica Coffee, and Kurg Arabica Coffee. Then the Gulbarga Tur Dal, which in English will be Kalaburgi Red Gram. So Red Gram is nothing but Tur Dal. It also got the GI tag. And Kolhapuri Chappal, for which Maharashtra and Karnataka both got the GI tag. And Karnataka was also number one in the SRAL index, that is State Rooftop Solar Attractiveness Index. It finished number one. And Karnataka has very recently got a loan of $91 million from the Asian Development Bank for improving their water resource quality. Where is the world's first Muslim yoga camp being held? World's first Muslim yoga camp is taking place in Kotdwar. Kotdwar is in Uttarakhand. It is in Uttarakhand. And the name of the place in Kotdwar is Kanwa Ashram. Kanwa Ashram. Uttarakhand's capital is Dehradun, where the first helicopter summit of India took place. And Achal Amrit Yojana was started by the government of Uttarakhand. Achal Amrit scheme. Trivendra Singh Rawat is the chief minister of Uttarakhand. And there is of course Rajaji and Jim Corbett, two tiger reserves in Uttarakhand. There are also World Heritage Sites like Valley of Flowers and Nanda Devi. They both are the World Heritage Sites. Yoga Day was celebrated on 21st of June. And it is celebrated on 21st of June because it is the longest day of the year, which is called Summer Solstice. That is why Yoga Day is celebrated on 21st of June. And this time there were two themes. One was Yoga for Climate Action, declared by UN. And second was Yoga for Heart by the government of India. Main event this year took place in Ranchi. Which is the focus country of the International Film Festival of India? And more importantly, what is the theme? The theme of the 50th International Film Festival of India is the joy of cinema. The joy of cinema is the theme of the International Film Festival of India. And the first film that will be shown is Despite the Fog. Despite the Fog. So the focus country is Russia. Russia. President Ramnath Kovind awarded the President's Colors to which institution or organization? President's Colors were given to the Indian Naval Academy. Indian Naval Academy, it is in Kochi, Kerala. And before this, presidential colors were also awarded to the Corps of the Army, Air Defense, and the Army Aviation Corps also in September and October 2019. And President of India recently visited two countries, Philippines and Japan. Philippines and Japan. And the Vice President of India recently visited two countries. One is Sierra Leone and one is Comoros. Comoros capital is Moroni and Sierra Leone capital is Freetown. Freetown. Vice President also went to Baku, but that's different. Which state has released the new land policy after 30 years? This state is Assam. Assam has released the new land policy. They launched a mobile app also called Shishu Suraksha and a housing subsidy scheme called Aponar Apon Ghar. And India's first detention center for the illegal immigrants is being made in the Golpara district. Because of the NRC, a lot of people will be declared who are not from India, who are illegally staying. All those will be put in the detention center being built in Golpara. Also, Guwahati and Dibrugarh, they both are located on the bank of Brahmaputra River. NASA scientists have recently detected water vapor on which Jupiter's moon? This moon is Europa. This is all a part of the Clipper mission. Clipper mission. Now Saturn has more moons than Jupiter. Saturn has now 82 moons. Which country has declared that Israeli settlements on West Bank do not violate international laws? It is America. So they seem to have reversed their policy towards Israel. America has declared that Israeli settlements on West Bank do not violate international laws. So they seem to be coming closer to Israel. India's youngest judge, who is he? Who is said to become India's youngest judge? What is his name? He is Mayank Pratap Singh. Mayank Pratap Singh, he cracked the Rajasthan Judicial Services exam. He is only 21 years of age. Only 21. who was formally elected as the 77th mayor of Mumbai. And as we speak, I have just got the confirmation that Devendra Fadnavis has become the new chief minister of Maharashtra. 77th mayor of Mumbai is Mr. Kishori Padnekar, Shiva Sena leader. Kishori Padnekar, she was a nurse earlier. It's a female. Sri Lankan President Gotabaya Rajapaksa will visit which country on 29th of November? This is going to be his first overseas visit. He is younger brother of Mahindra Rajapaksa, who most likely will become the new Prime Minister of Sri Lanka. So Gotabaya Rajapaksa will visit India. And this was a proactive step by India. They sent S. Jayashankar to Sri Lanka to finalize it. And Sri Lanka, recently Jaffna Airport has been inaugurated. So his first overseas visit is to India. Which state has launched a new scheme for senior citizen called Savera? It has been launched by the police of this state. It is Uttar Pradesh. I've already explained to you this scheme. In Savera, the police will come to the senior citizens and not the other way around. Name the first woman pilot of the Indian Navy who will join the naval operations on 2nd of December. She is from Muzaffarpur in Bihar. So huge moment of pride for Bihar. And what is her name? Her name is Shivangi. Which disease was responsible for the mass death of migratory birds at the Sambar Lake? So in Sambar Lake, 20,000 birds died because of this toxin. It is avian botulism. Avian botulism toxin. Very, very important question. And this was confirmed by the scientists from the Indian Veterinary Research Institute, which is in Bareilly. Okay, Indian Veterinary Research Institute, it is in Bareilly. When was the World COPD Day observed? Chronic Obstructive Pulmonary Disease. It was observed on 20th of November. And what was the theme? The theme was All Together to End COPD. And the World Pneumonia Day is 12th of November. And the theme was Healthy Lungs for All. Oxford Dictionary has declared which word as the word of the year for 2019. The word is climate emergency. It is word of the year by Oxford Dictionary because this word was used almost 10,000 times more than the previous year in 2019. So that's it. That was the video 23rd of November. I will see you very soon on 24th of November video. Thank you so much for watching StudyIQ Premium.